Hello, everybody, and welcome. My name is Carrington Maddox.
And my...
And my name is Imani Patel, and we are part of the effervescent class of 2023.
We would like to welcome you guys with opening prayer. Please bow your heads and close your eyes.
Dear Heavenly Father, we have gone through many trials and errors through our time being here, and the times we spent together were invaluable. With that being said, let us bring honor to those memories by vowing to not live lives of complacency, but ones of great success and fulfillment.
God, we ask that you guide us through this next portion of our life as we cry, laugh, and celebrate together. An unknown author once said, in order to get something you've never had, you have to do something you've never done. With that being said, God, give us the courage to take that risk. Success doesn't come from being comfortable, so give us the strength to be bold. In your name, amen. Amen.
Again, we welcome you. Thank you. Oh, this one.
Good morning, friends and family. My name is Nabu Sandy.
My name is Ryan Samuel.
I am a four-year senior.
And I am a three-year senior.
And we are part of the effervescent class of 2023.
Today is the final ceremony of our graduation weekend, known as our commencement. One definition of commencement is a beginning or a start, which is just what today is. Some people may view today as the end. However, we are choosing to celebrate it as the start of some new wonderful chapters in our lives. We choose to push forward and strive for more.
As we celebrate, we sincerely thank mothers, fathers, grandparents, guardians, aunts, uncles, brothers, sisters, cousins, and friends through supporting us through this turbulent time in our lives. God has truly allowed us to
God has truly blessed us by allowing us to make it
to the graduation stage.
Thank you all.
Distinguished guests, esteemed faculty, proud parents, families, and friends, the Board of Trustees, Principal Reynolds, Vice Principal Rhodes, to the class of 1973 and to the effervescent graduating class of 2023. I say, amen. God has blessed you. And at this time, I'd ask the audience to join with me as we honor them. Let's give them a round of applause. This is your day, the day to celebrate, to thank God for having brought you this far on your journey. Many started out with you on this journey, but they didn't make it here today. That should humble us and remind us that you're special in God's sight. Because of you, your parents sacrificed to make sure you get this education, to give you an eternal advantage, a fresh start in life. Believe it or not, you leave here debt-free. So I would like to give the parents a hand of applause at this time. Allegheny East Conference wants you to know we invest in you also. For each one of you, each year we invest $10,000 to $12,000 a year in your education because we believe in you. And we expect you not only to make it, but to excel in life. If you read your bulletin, you'll realize this is 77 continuous years of education here at Pine Forge Academy. And if you just take a look to your right, you will see what you can become. We have over here representing educators, physicians, teachers, lawyers, writers, actors, ministers. And if you look at the TV recently, you recognize the first African-American chaplain of the United States Senate, also a graduate of Pine Forge Academy. So at this time, I'd like to recognize our Board of Trustees. Those who are Board of Trustees members in the audience, won't you stand at this time? They work in the background, making sure the policies and procedures of the school are carried out in a way that would help you advance in your life's journey. So on behalf of Lawrence Martin, who our Chief Financial Officer, who many of you know, and Gary Wimbush, Vice President of Administration, we would like to let you know we are very proud of you. And look, we look forward to seeing you again, not as students, but as alumni, as those who join us in being partners investing in Pine Forge Academy. For those who don't know, this year our Executive Committee of Allegheny East Conference voted to start a project of $2.5 million of the renovation of Handy Hall and the bathrooms in our girls' dorm. And I want to say that's just the beginning, $2.5 million. It's worth every dime in our students. But we can't do this alone. We need everyone participating, everyone doing their fair share. So as you leave here and you get your jobs, and you will get jobs, and you will work, and you will enjoy your work because you've been paid for it, please remember Pine Forge in your giving. Now, as I conclude my remarks today, I want to recognize, on behalf of Allegheny East Conference, the 2023 Pine Forge Female Student of the Year, Arielle Prevett. We have a check for you. Isn't she beautiful? Carice Reynolds, salutatorian for the class. We have a check for you. You can get the one. Also, I want to recognize our males 2023 Pine Forge Student of the Year, Christian Stepney. We have a check for you. I will give it to you later. And also, Kristen Stepney is the valedictorian of the class of 2023. To set the tone right, God bless you.
Good morning, everyone. Let's just, before I even start, I'm just looking at this class. First, I want to say it is a privilege to stand before you, because I'm looking at doctors, lawyers, maybe the next president. But let's give them a round of applause for their achievements. Parents, teachers, staff, Principal Reynolds, Principal Rhodes, and the effervescent graduating class of Pine Forge Academy. Students, this momentous occasion marks the end of your high school journey and the beginning of a new chapter in your lives. I want to extend my warmest congratulations to each and every one of you on this special day. As students of Pine Forge Academy, you have been privileged to receive an education that not only focuses on academic excellence, but also nurtures your spiritual growth. You have been surrounded by a community that has encouraged you to develop a strong moral compass, embrace faith, and strive for a deeper understanding of the world around you. This holistic approach to education has prepared you to face the challenges that lie ahead with unwavering strength and resilience. In a world that often seems chaotic and uncertain, the principles and values instilled in you during your time here is more important than ever. Pine Forge has taught you to strive for excellence, never conform, and know your worth. It is these values that will guide you as you navigate the complexities of college and beyond. Now, Pine Forge is not cheap. So take a moment to express your gratitude to those who will make sure that you're here today. Give your parents a round of applause, your aunts, your uncles, all of those individuals who have played an instrumental role in your success. Thank your principals, your teachers, your deans, and the PFA staff. Let's give them a round of applause for what they've done to make sure that you get here. And thank your parents and families for their unwavering support and love. And most importantly, thank God for the opportunities and blessings bestowed upon you throughout your academic journey. May your future be filled with blessings, joy, and success beyond measure. As your superintendent, I am incredibly proud of each and every one of you, and I cannot wait to witness the incredible impact you will make on the world. Congratulations once again, and may God's grace be with you every step of the way. Congratulations.
We made it back from Hawaii, and I want to first of all I have some incredible chaperones. I want to thank Ms. Tracy Carroll for coming with us. I want to thank Dean Critchlow and his wife Jessica Roseboro, who came with us. Thank you. And we also, Ms. Blackwood, where are you? Ms. Blackwood, come on. She has stood by these kids. Now listen, every Thursday night we have to, they want to celebrate they've been celebrating since we started school. And Dean Blackwood has made sure that the times that we could make sure that they had a nice celebration that they could. Anytime that we have the ladies or the young men who wanted to go to Walmart when the bus wasn't going, she made sure that they did that. She has been standing and helping and working alongside me, trying to get everything together. So we want to give Mrs. Blackwood a big round of applause. There are 35 roses for each one of you. Now, there's one for me, because I know I can be a pain, but thank you so much. Of the year. We have two of them this year. Now listen, this teacher has picked up the slack for our math department and done an outstanding job. And also, when we didn't have a track coach, she picked it up. She ran with the baton, and she did that. Miss Francis, teacher of the year. Listen, if I could, I would give every last one of our staff members an award because they deserve it. So give them one big round of applause. At Pine Forge, you have to not only wear the hat that God called you to wear as teacher or dean or chef or custodian, whatever, but you have to also wear like five more hats. And I want to say, we have another teacher of the year, Mrs. Alita Baker, who stepped in and helped us. She is our everything technology. Without her, we would not have made it through this year. So Mrs. Baker, thank you so much. I want to say this year we had an outstanding parents association. Listen, we had parents that just said, I'm just going to help y'all. Y'all need some help. We did, and they have done an outstanding job. And so we want to give our president, Pastor Prevett, just tell him that he has done an awesome job this year. Now, Pastor Prevett, he has made sure his wife has helped us. He's made sure anybody in the church helped us, but he's also had Dr. Linda Dreyer, who also helped us. She helped in the dorm. She is our everything. Anything, anywhere we need some help, she is doing it. And so on behalf of her, please accept this award for her for one of our outstanding parents of the year. She's a grandparent, but we praise her. Two more, you know, there are some people that just stand behind the scenes, but these two people don't just stand behind the scenes, they drive behind the scenes. If we did not have them, we would not be able to go anywhere. Listen, we bought a new bus, and so we praise the Lord, but we didn't have anybody to drive it. I love it. That's the calling that's on our lives, is that we buy stuff, get it, but we're looking for God to fulfill the mission. And Shelbourne Richardson, stop. Yes. If his dad is here, he stopped his job several times during the year because we needed him. He went on vacation because we needed him. He brought kids to back and forth to the airport because we needed him. And so we want to thank him today. Pastor Richardson, would you come up and accept this for your son, please? And Mr. Calvin Taylor. Mrs. Taylor. Listen, Mr. Taylor is already everything at AEC. If anything is broken or needed or help, he's already doing that. But he also said, well, I'll help y'all because y'all don't have a bus driver. And he has helped us throughout the years. And we really appreciate it. He went on long, long trips with this group. Our longest trip to Oakwood, all night long we stayed in the bus and we drove all night. So we want to thank him for an outstanding, and this is his wife who also wears several hats, work in the CAF and also works in our business office. So we thank the family as well.
Every year, the Columbia Union provides us a scholarship and award for an outstanding student. This outstanding student has an outstanding Christian character. They go out of their way to help others. They go out of their way to be a servant of God as a pathfinder and a friend to man. This year, we're excited to present this award to Ms. Azriel Prevett. This award is called the Caring Heart Award. She will receive a scholarship amount. I'm not going to tell you. I'm sure she's going to be excited when she reads it. This comes from the Columbia Union. She has been an amazing student this year. She's Student of the Year, and I am proud to have her as a student at Pine Forge. Thank you, Azzy.
Class of 2023, what's up? Congratulations. I stand here representing a class that graduated 50 years ago. These guys over here. And should life last? Should we still be here on this earth and God has not come back for us? 50 years from now, I hope that all of you will be standing and present when you recognize the class of 20, what will it be? 20, whatever, okay. A long time from now. So I would say to you then that you all are to be commended. Special class that has come through the COVID, and that puts you at another level, all right? I have two gentlemen standing with me today, and I just need to let you know what the deal is. Dr. Mead Van Putten on my left, Dr. Oliver Nelson on my right. My father, Dr. Adrian Wesney, was the principal of Pine Forge for 8 years. So I was the principal's son. And if I got in trouble, it was double, okay? In addition, though, Dr. Van Putten's father was also conference secretary and president. Dr. Nelson's mother was our class sponsor, Mrs. Eileen Nelson. She taught French, Spanish, and the languages. Unfortunately, she passed away just a few months ago. But we want to acknowledge and let you know that you have here standing in front of you people who lived here, people who matriculated through here, and people who have done very well in the course of life. Now, a couple more things. lest you think that 50 years ago, you won't be able to stand. I'm gonna ask our class president, Lonnie Williams, to just wave or stand, man. We are blessed to have our class president here. The secretary of the class was Miss Lauren Timpson. Lauren is here and she's responsible for pulling us all together. So whoever is your class secretary now, you just take notes from her because you're gonna pull these guys together at 20 and 30 and 50 years from now, okay? All right, finally, we don't have Mrs. Nelson here, and we don't have my father who has passed away, but would you believe that my mother, Dr. Lizette Westney, his wife, is in the house somewhere? Just stand up. Mom, where are you? Stand up. She is 96 years old. There she is. She taught English here at Pine Forge. Yes. And she insisted on being here. We were going to leave her at home. I'm just putting my business on the street. We're going to leave her at home. Mom, you can't walk. I don't feel like pushing the wheelchair. She said, I am going to be there. And there she is. Now, two more things real quick. My brother here, I've forgotten your name. They said it so fast. You are the valedictorian and you're the student of the year, male student of the year.
What? Hey, Christian.
Christian, all right.
Just come here.
Fifty years ago, I was also the valedictorian of the class and student of the year of my peak. The other significant thing about this is that not only all of us were residents here at Pine Forge, so when the dorms closed and everything left, it was just us, okay? Dr. Van Putten was a salutatorian for the class of 1973. All right. Finally, my charge to you. You may not understand this now, but listen to me, please. The Almighty will contract with you.
That's right. Yep.
If you contract with the Almighty. Okay? Get it. That's not lip service. That is real rubber meets the road. Okay? And the Almighty is so loving, God will keep his part of the bargain even when you don't. All of us are living examples and testimonies of that. But in love, we may wander, but he allows us to come back. Okay? So don't be concerned that you will not be taken care of. Because you're here at Pine Forge, you already got a contract with the Almighty. So you just keep your part of the bargain. Secondly, and finally, you have come here and matriculated here, whether it's 2, 3, 4 years. I'm a 4-year student. And I think there's a couple other 4-year students here. There they are, yeah, Lauren. We all of us in our various professions, now 50 years later, have realized that we were prepared for something here at Pine Forge that we didn't know. In other words, your preparation, let me say it this way, you are prepared way beyond what you think. so that when you get into situations, people, places, whatever, jobs, and you're trying to figure out, oh man, this is tough. And you will discover, because of your contract with the Almighty, you already know this. You already got this. And if you now begin to put your trust in God and understand that you are already prepared, there is no limit to what your service will be on this earth. To the one class that is more illustrious than the class of 73, 1973. The one class.
That's right.
The class of 2023. Give it up to them.
I really appreciate AT and in the memory of my mom. She actually died a couple years ago. Beverly Vino, Dr. Beverly Vine, she taught her. I actually went to the little elementary school from fifth grade over there in the little gray building. Went through the school. My mother left, went to Andrews for 1 year, and then I came back and graduated. So I teach at Indiana University at the Jacobs School of Music. And I just wanted to let you guys know something. That's something I see for 40,000 kids that go to that school. GPA is not the all and end all. You don't go to school for a GPA. You go to school to learn. Get that in your minds right now, because once you get out, nobody cares about the GPA. They care about what you can do. And we want you to have a good GPA, so you want to do that. Do the best you can, but just remember, it's all about what you do. The character, the integrity that this school gives through Jesus Christ will take you a long way. I got my bachelor's degree in 77, I got my master's degree in 97, and I got my doctorate in 2016. And the Lord carried me all those ways. He'll do the same for you. Keep in touch with him. Make him your personal savior, and you can go anywhere you want to go for him.
Quick word. He's right. Both of these gentlemen are right. They're absolutely right. I worked for 32 years at Ohio State. Frank Hill brought me there, believe it or not. The Lord blessed me there. He got me through. I taught dental students. I'm a dentist. But I actually did more. I worked in the cancer hospital. How I got there is only by the Lord's grace and mercy. So you are prepared better than you think. And God will bless you as you stay in his hand and let him work for you. Thank you.
is a coming up, coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock, shout, shout, I'm coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock is a coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock, shout, shout, I'm coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock is a coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock, shout, shout, I'm coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock is a coming up, Lord.
Satan's a conjurer and a liar too, and if you're not careful, he will conjure you. If you don't believe that I've been redeemed, how would you follow me down to that Jordan Street? I'm on down.
I'm coming up, Lord, Elijah Rock. He's a coming up, Lord, oh, Elijah Rock. Shout, shout, I'm coming up, Lord, Elijah Rock. He's a coming up, Lord, oh, Elijah Rock. Shout, shout, I'm coming up, Lord, Elijah Rock. He's a coming up, Lord, oh, Elijah Rock.
Oh, Rock Elijah, you better come on, get up, oh, Rock Elijah. I know you hear me talking, oh, Rock Elijah, with the word of the Lord. The Lord is your presence, and yes, you're gonna come through, yes, you will.
Elijah Rock, shout, shout, I'm coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock, he's a coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock, shout, shout, I'm coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock, he's a coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock, jump, jump, I'm coming up, Lord. He's a-coming, Lord. Elijah Rock, jump, jump, I'm coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock, he's a-coming, a-coming, a-coming.
Get up and run. morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Katherine Goodrich, and I am the president of the Effervescent Senior Class of 2023. I count it an honor to have this opportunity to share a few words with my classmates as we prepare to graduate from our beloved Pine Forge Academy. First of all, let me say a few thank yous. To the Board of Trustees, thank you for believing in the mission of Pine Forge Academy and for ensuring that it remains viable for the foreseeable future. To the administration, faculty, and staff, thank you for your hard work and dedication in carrying out the mission of Pine Forge Academy and for sacrificing your time, money, and energy in teaching, molding, and leading us to be the best we can be. To our parents, families, and supporters, thank you for believing in us, sacrificing your money, helping us when we need it, giving your money, listening to us when we call and we would barely be able to hear each other because of the bad reception, and spending your money, encouraging us when we're down, forking over your money, sending care packages, handing over your money, being a shoulder for us to cry on, and parting with all your money so that we could stand here today on the brink of graduation. To God, thank you for making all of this possible and for giving us the strength to live, move, and have our being. To my fellow class officers, Jaden, Sarah, Akia, Elijah, Kyla, Ethan, Ryan, Chris Sandy, Kristen, Cam, Kamali, Cairo, Jada, and Carl, thank you for the hard work, time spent, and support throughout the school year. And finally, to my classmates, the Effervescent Class of 2023, what a journey. Whether you have been here for 4 years or only one, we have overcome. When we came to Pine Forge, we had no idea what we were getting into. We came from all over the country and even the world, hoping to fit in, hoping to make friends, hoping that things would be okay. In the first few days and weeks when we tried to make friends, tried to figure out teachers, who would be easy, who would be tough, tried to get used to the routine of the dorm life, tried to determine what we could get away with and what we couldn't, it was an adjustment. Yet slowly but surely we settled down and settled into the life at Pine Forge. We made friends, we made the adjustment, we made the best of our new situation. Then COVID hit and we were abruptly sent home. We're sent home to isolation and vaccination. We're sent home to Zoom rooms and e-learning. We're sent home to worry about whether we would catch COVID and if we would ever see each other again in person. Some of us thrived during lockdown, but others of us didn't. Our mental health suffered, our grades suffered, our friendships suffered. What we thought would be weeks turned into months and even a year. Then we returned to school. We had to wear masks, keep social distancing, and quarantine. We had to constantly risk getting dorm points for sneaking in and out of each other's rooms just to get 5 minutes together. It seemed that our high school experience was being taken away from us without our consent or without our control. And yet, we overcame. In some ways, we got closer knowing that when we saw each other fully in person, it was something that we dare not take for granted. When we sang from experience. When we expressed ourselves creatively, we shared our experience. When we performed even for and to ourselves, we were authentic. This is our experience. This was our black. During our time here, we have lost some classmates and gained some new ones. We have laughed together, cried together, fought together, made mistakes together, learned together, grown together, and overcome together. When I came to Pine Forge, I was in a bad place. I wasn't sure if I would make it one semester, let alone 4 years. And there were even times where I wanted to give up. There were times I wondered if I would make it to graduation, but there were also even dark times where I wondered if I would make it at all. But as I stand here now, I can say thank God I made it. Thank God we made it. Mm. with sisters like Sarah, Jaden Jacob, Jeremy, Jewel, Jada Good, Maya, Kamali, Jaden Butler, Kristen, Taeja, Jada Ampadu, Gabby, Akia, Amani, Karis, Kelsey, Ryan, Kyla, and Michaela, and with brothers like Christian, Jalen, Cam, Carl, David, Ever, Chun, Ethan, Michael, Jamil, Carrington, Jamal, Cairo, Chrisandy, and Elijah, I can truly say that I have found not friends, but family who love and accepts me for who I am and I them. With deans like Dean Marshall, Dean Blackwood, Dean Anderson, Dean Audie, and Dean Krishlow, we have found second moms and dads. With administration, faculty, and staff like PR, VP Rhodes, CHAP, Mr. Roseboro, Ms. Carroll, and Pastor Richardson, we have found role models, mentors, and everything we need them to be at the time. We will never forget the worship, the deep discussions, the times we shouldn't have gotten in trouble, the times we got into trouble, and the times we should have gotten into trouble, but we weren't caught. We will never forget being vulnerable on choir trips, being silly on school trips, being adventurous on senior class trip, and being what some may call haunted on Walmart trips. We will never forget those amazing moments and memories. We have overcome, and we are the effervescent class of 2023. We can do anything. A pandemic cannot stop us. Injustice cannot stop us. Uncertainty cannot stop us. Chaos cannot stop us. Deadlines cannot stop us. Obstacles cannot stop us. Unrealistic expectations cannot stop us. Lack of resources cannot stop us. We are the effervescent class of 2023. Everywhere we go, we bring life, energy, happiness, fun, spirit, joy, and resilience. Though these experiences have been amazing, we may feel we did it on our own, but please don't ever forget where we came from and who we came from. Cherish your friendships. Cherish your moms, cherish your dads, your grandparents, aunts, uncles, and cousins. Show kindness, show compassion. You never know what people's situations are. Life is hard enough. Most importantly, cherish and nurture your relationship with God. He is the only way to get through this thing called life. He has brought you through so much. Show your gratitude. Don't let a temporary decision cause you to be subjected to a permanent situation. Time waits for no one. God loves you. Your friends and family love you. Embrace it. In closing, I leave you with a chorus to a song my dad used to play for me. Give them all, give them all, give them all to Jesus. Shattered dreams, wounded hearts, broken toys. Give them all, give them all, give them all to Jesus, and he will turn your sorrows into joy. Class, parents, Pine Forge Academy, give it all to Jesus, no matter how big or small, for he will turn your sorrows into joy. Thank you.
How y'all doing?
Oh, no.
Oh, here we go. So this is what we're going... Is it
in here?
Okay, here we go. There we go. This is what we're going to do. If I start to go fast, if you raise your hand up, I'll either repeat or slow down. Does that work? So we'll do a test run. I'm so happy to be here today. Okay, perfect. So the more hands, the easier it'll be to notice, okay? Okay, before I formally begin my speech... I want to give a special thanks to my family, the teachers, and all supporting staff of the past or present who have once walked, or the past or present students who have once walked in my shoes and ultimately poured into my journey here at Pine Forge. Classes like the class of 2020, 2021, and 2022. I thank you all. I also want to acknowledge everyone who has financially poured into my education. I stand here today with deep gratitude saying thank you all. Thank you. The title of my speech is Get Straight, Don't Hesitate. Dear fellow graduates, dear fellow graduates, faculty members, and distinguished guests, I am honored to stand before you today, firstly as a vessel, nothing special, an unworthy servant fulfilling my assignment, and secondly, by the grace of God, the valedictorian of the effervescent class of 2023. My name is Christian Stepney from Columbus, Ohio, born and raised on the playground. That's where I spend most of my days. And it is with great satisfaction and humility that I accept this distinction, knowing that it represents not only my achievements, but also those of my classmates. Yet, as I stand here today, I can't help but assert with such certainty that this celebration here today would not have been possible without the divine intervention of our Creator, who appointed this class to be the class that was entrusted with the burden of navigating through a significantly dark season for our nation and our education. You see, the effects of COVID-19 wounded many of us, but the main question is not how we hide our wounds, but how we can put our woundedness in service to others. And the class of 2023 is a class that has chosen to use our wounds as confirmation of God's goodness, mercy, and grace. Theodore Roosevelt said, "Keep your eyes on the stars and your feet on the ground." You see, the class of 2023, we are a byproduct of preordained warriors who kept the end in mind, looking to the promise that God preserved for us amid the wilderness we were taxed to endure. The important thing is not the triumph, but the struggle. We weren't convinced how we would get here today, but you see, faith is daring the soul to go beyond what the eyes can see. Faith means trusting in advance what would only make sense in reverse. And we are officially today marking the day we are coming out of training camp, which was a grueling journey full of challenges and obstacles. But we've pushed through and come out on the other side more prepared than ever before. As we prepare for the real war ahead, we must remind ourselves that it wasn't our strength that has gotten us this far, but rather the grace of our official training camp director, God, that carried us through. With the intense training and preparation that we have undergone these past few years, we can now officially put our skills to the test while leaning on God and His understanding to finish out strong. But today, I'm not sure many will like what I have to say, but I believe a lesson learned needs to be a lesson shared, and things that hurt instruct. So today, I have not stood up here to just say the proverbial journey that each of us is aware of, but I was assigned to warn you. Today, I must warn you that self-delusion is a powerful drug that keeps many of our brothers and sisters in Christ addicted, and as a result, deceived. You see, most believe the future is uncertain, but the end is inevitable for us who know what's to come. Every path has two ways, forwards or backwards. You can either lean on you and your flesh and give it to the enemy, or you can lean on God who claims the victory. As we march into battle, let us recognize that we must make the decision now or pay the price in the future, reminding ourselves that indecision is a fatal decision. You see, the purpose of life is a life of purpose. Mark Twain said, "The two most important days in your life are the day that you were born and the day that you find out why." As the children of God, we were created to serve, praise, and glorify Him in all that we do and say. Class of 2023, believe in God with all of your tenacity, and He will give you far more valuable treasures than that what the world can offer you. I stand here today as a focused testimony, professing that I wasn't always presence focused on God. Still, in spite of my neglect, He chose me and had a plan for me. It wasn't until I decided to take Him seriously, turn my face to Him for my success, and leave the glorifying to Him that life here at Pine Forge Academy became clear. I wasn't good by human standards. And many people today, class of 2023, will look at you expecting you to be a failure. However, let me be the one to remind you that their discernment issue is not your identity issue. It's not your fault that they don't know you are chosen, anointed, and special. Because nobody, and I say nobody, nobody is obligated to understand or support your assignment here on earth. All you are required to do is to be obedient. Don't allow culture to define what it did not create. God sees you for the version He created you to be. Let mistakes be your school, not your prison. Learn from them, but don't be bound by them. Rather, leave it to God to put his super on your natural. All he desires is for you to come humbly to his throne, repent, lay down your cross, and let him complete what he made you for. Start getting presence focused. Make sure your target is clear. Once you look at Jesus for direction, success is the only option. Focus on the only option. Love, being taken care of, a good reputation, and strong relationships are a byproduct of serving the giver of all good things. What I'm saying to you today is you begin to look like what you look at most. So class of 2023, look at Jesus as the cornerstone and measure of your faith. I'll even put it this way, class of 2023, I am here asserting that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and all he wants for you to do is to get straight with him and don't hesitate. Choose him and let him complete the work that he started. If God is not the aim of your life, you will forever be off target. You see, but God, we serve a graceful God who just wants to see the work begin. Zechariah 4:10 states, "Do not despise these small beginnings, for the Lord rejoices to see the work begin." You see, small tweaks lead to high peaks. Take it one step at a time. Remember to stare, not the staircase. Focus on one step at a time. The process is just the stair. You see, culture traffics in speed, but God traffics in steps. You may be asking yourself, what are steps? Well, let me tell you, steps are strategies to establish produce seasonally. Steps are strategies to establish produce seasonally. You see, God desires us to be a people who produce fruit consistently that is symmetrical to his character. Do not sacrifice your future peace because familiar chaos is comfortable. As you reach higher than the highest heights that God has for you, remember, success is not fame, status, or fortune, boyfriends or girlfriends, but true success is obedience in God's presence. Today, we are making a direct declaration that we will give ourselves wholly to God to learn the way and will of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. This, might I assert, is the highest education one can acquire, which is to build our experience not on the fallacies of this world, but rather on the eternal. As we leave this place that for some of us was a second or third home, or the family we never really had, let me remind you that this is just the genesis of our story, and we have only just begun. Let us press forward and embrace the uncertainty. Let us continue to get back up when we fall and run to win the race that's been laid out for us, keeping our eye on the prize that soon and very soon our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is patiently waiting to return and declare to his flock, "Well done, thy good and faithful servant." Will you, class of 2023, choose to be a faithful steward of the gifting that God has given you? You see, God has given all of us a gift so that we can reveal who he truly is. And to close, I want you all to know, whether you know it or not, I'm saying it in front of this crowd, that I love each and every one of you very, very much. And you all mean everything to me. I love you with my entire soul, and I appreciated and cherished every moment, whether it be long or short, that we spent together. Let me close with this. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord smile on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you his favor and give you his peace. Thank you.
My name is Jaden Butler.
And I'm Jamal Nelson.
And we are a part of the effervescent class of 2023. Harry L. Williams serves as president and CEO of the Thurgood Marshall College Fund, the nation's largest organization exclusively presenting the black college community.
TMCF's 47 member schools are America's publicly supported, historically black colleges and predominantly black institutions, educating nearly 300,000 students. Under his leadership as president and CEO, TMCF has created innovative partnerships, increased organizational stability, and advanced bipartisan HBCU support.
A strategic thinker and visionary, Williams concluded dedicated talent development partnership with leading corporations such as the Bojean Company, Medtronic, Visa, Ally Financial, and Hennessy USA. He successfully re-imaged long-term partnership with companies such as Lowe's, the NBA, and Wells Fargo, cementing TMCF as the premier source of major employers seeking top diverse talent for competitive internship and corporate careers.
Under Williams, TMCF has experienced tremendous growth, expanded its revenue threefold, and doubled its corporate partnerships. His leadership has solidified TMCF as the premier representative of the HBCU community, a hub for insight into the black college community and the families that they serve, a convener of HBCU-based researchers, and as a key partner for diverse talent and inclusion strategies. Williams places a strong emphasis on creating bipartisan alliances.
TMCF has been at the forefront leading on every significant national legislative victory for HBCUs, earning respect and trust from elected and appointed leaders on both sides of the aisles in Congress and in the White House. In 2019, TMCF's first legislative priority, the Future Act, became law after successfully forging a coalition and identifying resources.
In 2020, TMCF successfully helped secure significant federal funding to help low-resource HBCUs meet financial challenges of COVID-19 and continue educating their students.
As a former HBCU president, Dr. Williams leveraged his relationship with other HBCU presidents to increase cooperation between TMCF member schools, create a supportive network among HBCU's leaders, providing a platform for sharing best practices, and acting together to ensure institutional stability for all HBCUs.
As president of Delaware State University, Williams enjoyed a successful 8-year tenure, increasing student enrollment and forging new public/private multi-million dollar partnerships, grants, and investments into the campus.
He has received many awards and accolades for his careers in higher education and previously held senior positions at the University of North Carolina General Administration and Appalachian State University and North Carolina A&T State University.
Dr. Williams earned his bachelor's and master's degree from Appalachian State University, a doctorate from East Tennessee State University, named President Emeritus of Delaware State University, and is a member of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated.
Most importantly, he is a family man. His wife is Dr. Robinson S. Williams, and they are the proud parents of two grown sons, Austin and Gavin. Austin and his wife, Regan, both graduated from Howard University. Gavin is also a Howard graduate and is now in his first year law student at Southern University Law Center. Dr. Williams also has a granddaughter, Porter Ray, who is the daughter of Austin and Regan. But before he comes, we will have a special selection by the Pine Forge Academy Choir.
At this time, as always, we would like to invite any of our Pine Forge Choir family to come and join us for this selection. This is Someday. Thank you.
Oh, Oh, Wow. I don't know why I'm here. I have absolutely no clue why I am here. There is so much talent in this room, I'm just blowing up. Oh, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. This is a day to celebrate excellence at the highest level. I am blown away. This is my first time in this beautiful part of the United States, and I am floored. I cannot believe what I am feeling today. And it is joy and happiness and pride and satisfaction and all great things. Before I move forward with my prepared remarks, I'd like again to acknowledge my wife, Dr. Robin Williams. Robin, where are you? Will you stand up? Do we see her? Okay. She's back there in the back. We are thrilled to be here. Dr. Jermaine Cheatham invited me to come to share a few words to the class of 2023. I am delighted to be with you. I am happy to be here with you. This is a special place. I feel the Spirit of the Lord here. And what I can say, in my journey, I have the privilege of interacting with more than 101 HBCUs. And I travel all over the country. This is my fourth commencement this year. I'm usually on a college campus giving a commencement address. And we spend a lot of time with excellence and black excellence. Let me emphasize, black excellence. And we celebrate that. And we celebrate that in a way that lifts up the spirit and lifts up the community, because that's what we represent. And being here today, I feel right at home, because I'm celebrating black excellence here. And again, before I get into my remarks, I want Catherine and Christian to stand up again. Where's Catherine and Christian? Where's Catherine? The president? She's in the restroom. I've heard a lot of speeches from young people. I have never, ever heard anything like I've heard today. Never. I don't know what you're gonna do, but it's gonna be big. It's gonna be big. I know that. I know that. I am claiming that today. Stay tuned. Stay tuned. It's going to be big. Really, really big. At the Thurgood Marshall College Fund, I get up every single day excited about the work that we do. We represent 47 public historically black colleges and universities. HBCUs in this country represent only less than 3% of higher education institutions in America. And there are over 4,000 universities in this country. And we have 101 HBCUs. And at Thurgood Marshall College Fund, we represent 80% of the students who attend historically black colleges and universities, which is about 300,000 students. Our friends at UNCF, which is a private representative, they represent the private HBCUs like Oakwood. But we all work together when it comes to HBCUs. But in this country, we represent less than 3% of higher ed. But 80% of the judges in the United States of America graduated from HBCU. 50% of the doctors in America graduated from HBCUs. 50% of the lawyers graduated from HBCU. So something is happening when you're small. Excellence rises up to the top. So we are excited to carry on the legacy of one of the greatest Supreme Court justices that ever lived on this planet, Justice Thurgood Marshall. Justice Thurgood Marshall and his family gave us the right 36 years ago. Our founder, Dr. N. Joyce Payne, actually went to the Supreme Court, met with Justice Marshall in his office, and asked him 36 years ago if we could use his name and likeness. And students, I want you to listen to what I'm saying here. This is part of your responsibility when you achieve greatness. It's not, you can't keep it all to yourself. You have responsibility to give back to the community. So our founder asked Justice Marshall if we could use his name to raise funds for black students attending the historically black colleges and universities. And he did not, let me be very clear, Justice Marshall didn't hesitate. He actually had his secretary to come in and write the letter giving us the rights and privilege, and I have a copy of that letter in my office in Washington, D.C. that he signed, giving us the rights and privileges to use his name and likeness to raise money, to meet with corporate leaders across the country, to open doors for our students to walk through. And I want you to listen to what I'm going to say here. By using his name, a name that is so powerful, a name, a giant in the legal profession, someone who argued before the highest court in the land, the United States Supreme Court, when he was an attorney with the NAACP Legal Defense Fund, argued 32 times and won 29 cases. A two-time HBCU graduate, graduated top of his class from Lincoln University, which is not too far from here, one of the oldest HBCUs in America. And then he went on to Howard University and earned his law degree and graduated top of his class. And after graduating, instead of going into corporate America and making millions, he went and set up an organization in New York with the NAACP to set up to argue cases to rip down laws in this country that will make it possible for us to move forward together. That's what he did with his life. And he was committed to that. He got up every single day focusing on how he's going to create opportunities that's going to make it better for all of us that's in this room here today. That's one man. That's one man. And our vision is very clear. Our vision is very clear. Preparing leaders for the next generation, one leader at a time. We're very clear with that. There is a term that we use in corporate America when we are preparing for the future. It's called future proofing. Future proofing. You can look it up. Future proofing is when our organization, like Pine Academy, Pine Forge Academy, where they prepare for the future. All of you have been future-proofed. And what that means is that nothing will knock you down because the faculty over here, they have prepared you for the future. That's called future-proofing. You have been prepared, they have prepared you for anything that will come your way. They have planted the seeds in you that you will use, and 50 years from now, you will come back just like the class of 1973, and three of you will stand up here like the class of 1973 and talk about the great things that you've accomplished in the 50 years. I promise you that. And that's because this institution has prepared you for the future. So you are future-proof. And being future-proof don't mean you know everything. You always have room for someone else to help you, someone else to provide you with some additional opportunities so that when those storms come, and they will come, when those storms come, you will be able to withstand anything that will come your way. When you're flying one of our partners called Boeing. Boeing is a big airline. And when you're flying on an airplane, sometimes you're up in the air and there's some things that's happening and the plane's just jumping all over the place. It's called turbulence. That turbulence, when you feel that turbulence, you feel like you're going to literally fall out of the air. It's one of the scariest feelings you ever want to feel in the air. But when you get through, what the pilot is looking for is that clear, smooth air. And when you get through, it's very smooth on the other side. And that's when you get there, then you feel that relief. So when you go through your turbulence in life, you're built to withstand the turbulence. And by going through it, it's going to prepare you for the next time you go through something that's tough. So what I want to leave with you today are seven keys for success. And I promise you, these keys will guide you. If you listen and you hold on to them. Because I was thinking about, what can I tell a group of 18-year-olds who are getting ready to grow, 17, 18, who's getting ready to go and start another journey? What can you use in life that's going to help you? You know what I went back to? I went back to my grandmother. I went back to when I was 18 years old. And I thought I could do anything I wanted to do. But my grandmother, who had a second grade education, and I loved her to death. My grandmother called me into the room and she said, Harry, I know you're gonna do some great things in life, but I wanna help you along the way. Some things that I have seen because I've been here a little bit longer than you. And we should always listen to our grandmother and grandfathers. Always listen to our grandmothers and our grandfathers. Because they have seen things that you haven't seen yet. And sometimes they can prepare you for the next chapter that will make it a lot easier for you to move forward. So my grandmother is someone I love. I listened to her every single day and night whenever she would be talking. And I was so humbled when she called me in and she said, Harry, I'm gonna give you seven keys that's gonna guide you for the rest of your life. And I promise you, you will be successful. I promise you, you will be successful. And I'm giving you my grandmother's keys. And my grandmother's saying, I want you to write them down. I know you don't have anything to write down because you're all smart. You're gonna remember them anyway. She said, key number one in life, when you get out in the world, key number one, my grandmother said, hold on to your faith. Don't let anything rock you. That faith will hold you. And you keep that number one in your life, your faith. And I guarantee you, when you run up into some difficult times, your faith will sustain you. It will get you through. It will make it possible for you to get up the next day and move forward. So hold on to your faith. Then my grandmother said, because you're going to be successful, and because a lot of people are going to be lifting you up, and you need to get used to that, get used to people lifting you up, but hold on to your family. Don't let anything come between you and your family. Your family will be there to celebrate you in the good times, and they'll be there to celebrate you when you need some additional attention. I know there's been many nights that you've been here where you needed to pick up that phone and you just need to hear your mother's voice on the other end of the line. And I promise you, there are gonna be more times in your life when you're gonna need to hear somebody that know you better than you know yourself, that can tell you you're gonna be okay, you're gonna be fine, and your family can do that. And I promise you, don't let anything get between you and your family, because your family will lift you up all the time. So always stay connected to your family. Never get too big. You're gonna be big, but never get too big that you can't call home to mom, that you can't call home to dad. And I promise you, they will stand there with you. Key number three, she said, you're ready to go out into the world, you're ready to go to college, be committed to your passion. Be focused. Get up every day thinking about your passion. One of the greatest scientists ever to live on this planet was George Washington Carver. George Washington Carver got up every single day, a scientist at Tuskegee University, one of our HBCUs, a man who created more than 100 different products from the peanut. Can you imagine the passion associated of getting up in the morning and looking at a peanut and trying to figure out what you can get out of it? That takes passion. That takes focus. That takes drive. George Washington Carver would have been the Bill Gates of his day. That's how he created, that's how big he was. That's what he did with agriculture in this country. Made it possible for us to learn about all the different things that we can do with our land called crop rotation. That's a significant, but he didn't get that by accident. It's because he was committed to his passion. Key number four, my grandmother said, write down your big goals on a piece of paper. And when you write them down, don't tell anybody your goals. Don't tell them your big goals. Because sometimes people like to discourage you. Sometimes people like to say, I can't see you doing that. And you don't want to get that doubt in your head. So have your goals written down. And write them down where they're going to be so big. Where it's going to be so big, it's going to require you to work harder than anything you've ever worked for in your life. And when you write those goals down, you check them off when you move forward. You put it down and make it plain and make it clear. And you speak it. You speak it, and I promise you, you will achieve that. I promise you. I used that key, that goal, when I said I wanted to be a president of an HBCU. I didn't tell a single soul. I kept it in my pocket. I kept the goals in my pocket. I looked at them every single day. I looked at the things I needed to do and prepared for that. I even put the time when I want to become a president. I can tell you the date, the time, when I wrote them down, the time I wrote them down, and how long I said it was going to take me to be the president. I said I wanted to do it in 10 years, and 10 years to the day, I was inaugurated as president of Delaware State University. And I promise you, that's simple. My grandmother told me to do that, and I did it. Key number five, plan for success. Success is in your DNA. Success is all around here. Plan for success. Plan for continued growth and process and moving forward. Always, always think towards the future. Always think towards successful future. I see it in you. I don't know any of you, but I can feel it. I can feel the spirit that's here, that you all are going to be successful. You are going to be successful. And these keys, only thing these keys are doing is keeping balance in your life. Don't get them out of order. If you take faith and put faith down to number three, I guarantee you'll start getting rocky. You'll fall. You'll wonder why you're falling. So keep them in order. We need balance in our life. And when you have balance, you can walk straight. And when you don't have balance, you will fall. And that's why it's important to keep faith, number one, and family, number two, and then number three is your career. You can make a lot of money, but if you don't have anybody to enjoy it with, you just made a lot of money. Key number six. Sometimes people see stuff in you that you don't see in yourself. So if someone comes to you and they say, I want to create an opportunity for you to go to California, you've never been there before. Be prepared to say, yes, I will go. And I know it's in you because you're here. Some of you are from all different parts of the country. So I know you understand Yes. Be prepared to say yes when opportunities come your way. And sometimes those opportunities may not fit into your frame of reference of where you think you want to be. But sometimes someone will see something and put you where you need to be. And when you say yes, that's when the blessings will flow. Sometimes we block our own blessings by saying no. So be prepared to say yes when those opportunities come your way, and they will come. And key number 7, always, always get up every day with a smile on your face and be positive. And I guarantee you, you surround yourself with people who are like you, people who are positive, people who are doing great things. You want to be a millionaire? Hang out with a millionaire. If you want to be, there's a reason why doctors go to medical school and all doctors stay together. Because when you're around, that's the energy. That energy will push you forward. That energy will make it possible for success. By using the name of Thurgood Marshall and by getting up every single day and surrounding ourselves with positive energy, this fund, we've been able to raise close to $500 million to support black students attending HBCUs. So it didn't happen by accident. It's very intentional, very focus driven. And that's what's so encouraging about the class of 2023. I feel good because I know I'm gonna be okay when I get to be in that group over there, in that category there. In the class of 73, when I get older, you're gonna need people like you to take care of us and take care of this world. So thank you, thank you, thank you for being the best that you are. And I'm just can't wait to see what's gonna happen. I circled your names in my book. I'm gonna keep them, and I'm gonna Google them 5 years from now. I'm gonna see where you are. Have a great day. Thank you.
Class of 2023, please rise. Dr. Robinson, Board of Trustee members, Superintendent John Alberty, Principal Reynolds, faculty and staff, the graduating class of 2023 has completed all of the requirements and have completed their matriculation here at Pine Forge Academy. And I believe they're ready to receive their diplomas. All right, young people, when your name is called, you will come to the podium, you'll walk and shake hands, make sure that you are on that end so that you can catch your picture. When you come back, sit so that we can see each group, all right? Catherine Goodrich. Graduating with honors, residence hall advisor, choir member, class president. Jaden Jacob. Graduating with high honors. Third generational legacy. Choir member, class officer. Sarah Bulgin. Graduating with honors, third generation legacy, USM officer, class officer, choir member, Akia Maxwell. Graduating with principal's list. Class officer, honor guard. Elijah Tyler. High honors. National Honor Society, class officer. Choir member, thank you. Kyla Tucker. Kyla is graduating with principal's list. National Honor Society. Honor Guard. Ethan Harris. Ethan is graduating with principal's list. Honor Guard, music diploma, RA in the dorm, Red Cross blood donor, choir member. Most of these are choir member. Kamali Broomfield. Kamali is graduating with honors, music diploma, choir member, class officer. If you all will sit, we'll let our family and friends, they can't see behind you. Have a seat, we'll just pull you one row at a time. You stay put. There you go. All right. Cairo Nora. Cairo is graduating with highest honors. Choir member, National Honor Society member, USM officer, and class officer. Ryan Samuel. Ryan is graduating with principal's list. USM officer, class officer, choir member, honor guard. Chris Naboo Sandy. choir member, class officer. Ryan's Kristen Dudley. Kristen is graduating with high honors, National Honor Society, USM Officer, Class Officer, Blood Drive Award, Choir Member, Honor Guard, Dance Troupe Leader. Cameron Bean. Cameron is graduating with honors. National Honor Society. Second Generation Legacy. Choir member, class officer. Jada Good. Jada is graduating with highest honors, National Honor Society, Music Diploma, Class Officer. Carl Brewer. Carl Brewer is graduating with high honors, Music Diploma, Second Generation Legacy, Class Officer, Honor Guard. Maya Ampadu. Maya is a choir member. David Britton. Jaden Butler, high honors, National Honor Society, Music Diploma. Ever Causey. Basketball and football teams. Christian Chun, choir member. Christian is graduating with honors. Joelle Clay. Joelle Clay is graduating with high honors,
and National Honor Society. She's also a member of the choir. Taisha Folston. High honors, choir member. Jada Gittens Ampadu. Honors. Jalen Harewood. High honors. National Honor Society, USM member. Residence Hall Advisor. Gabrielle Jones, Residence Hall Assistant, Choir Member. Michael Hayes, Honors. Jameel Joseph, choir member. Carrington Maddox. Honors, National Honor Society, USM member, second generation legacy, music diploma. Jamal Nelson. Honors. NHS, National Honor Society member. Amani Patel. Honors. Kelsey Reed. High honors, National Honor Society, third generation legacy, music diploma, honor guard, NIST. Horace Reynolds, Salutatorian, Principals List, National Honor Society, USM Member, Second Generation, Music Diploma, MIPS Participant, Honor Guard. Jeremy Smith, Honors, National Honor Society. Christian Stepney, Valedictorian, National Honor Society, USM Member, Third Generation Legacy, Honor Guard, RA. Michaela Weber, Honors, Second Generation Legacy, Music Diploma. There are a few things we want to note about this class. And I'm gonna hopefully, I'm trying to give Michaela her moment. As you have noticed, and gentlemen, you may be seated. As you have noticed, we have a very talented class. Within this class, we have a core group of young people who have been in choir for the entire time that they were here, or just a year or so. I'd like for choir members in this class to stand. You may be seated. But I don't want to slight our other group, because they are just as powerful in their presentation. They put in just as much work, and this year they began to travel again. If you are in creative arts, our drama group, will you please stand? The students who were in creative arts have a brown cord around their neck, if you didn't see that. They also have a special pin from a creative arts leader. We are excited about what the Lord has done for them. I'm gonna ask our registrar to come, and we have some special awards that we'd like to take care of. Young people, when you hear your name, move expeditiously.
We will begin with a mathematics award. These are students that took all four required math and a higher math and successfully passed them. When you hear your name, move very quickly. Elijah Tyler. Karis Reynolds. Akia Maxwell. Ethan Harris. And Joelle Clay. These young people took AP Calculus this year and survived. We have several students that were inducted into the National Honor Society as seniors. We'd like to recognize them as well. Catherine Goodridge. Jaden Butler. Jamal Nelson. Kyla Tucker. Carrington Maddox. Elijah Tyler. Kelsey Reed. Jalen Harewood. Joelle Clay. And Cameron Bean.
Good afternoon. I'm Eldridge Edgecombe, the Academy's business manager. And so you can imagine what's on my mind. Money. The good news is that it does not relate to any of our fine graduates here today from the class of 2023. Howsomever, earlier in the program, you heard from President of the Alleghenies Conference, Dr. Marcellus Robinson, that with the support of the Alleghenies Conference, the Academy has begun an ambitious rehabilitation program of both dormitories. So that when the students return, not these graduates, but those that precede them or follow them, they will return to dormitories that have been fully rehabilitated. Those of you who have any familiarity with the construction process know that when you do rehabilitation, there are always surprises. The unexpected happens and occurs. I can assure you, this project of the Academy has already developed surprises, which essentially means more money is needed. The Alleghenies Conference committed upfront $2.5 million, which was the cost estimate that we were given a year ago, more than a year ago. Of course, lots have happened in the last year. Interest rates have climbed to the sky. Supply chains have been disrupted. So now, a project that we thought was 2.5 million is now $6 million. That, my dear friends, is not a burden that we should place upon the Allegheny's Conference. We, the alumni, friends, supporters, we have the capacity within us to provide the additional funding. I can tell you that there's already a small group being less than a handful, three to be precise, have committed $300,000 already. Howsomever, as you can do the math, we still have a long way to go. So, I implore you today to step up to the plate with whatever you have. Don't say, my contribution is too small. No contribution is too small. And as always, no contribution is too large. Do what you can based on how God has blessed you. And you will in turn be re-blessed again. Thank you. We look forward to your support.
We have quite a number of scholarships. This is a very bright class. They've done well. We really want to move quickly. So young people, when you hear your name, move as quickly as possible so that we can get through. I'd like to start off with a scholarship from the Message of Hope International Ministries Incorporated group. This scholarship is given to a student who has experienced more of life than most at that age. And they are awarded $2,500 annually for 4 years towards their college tuition. The student that has been awarded this scholarship is Miss Amani Patel. Congratulations, Amani. These awards are from Southern Adventist University. Sarah Bulgen, $20,000. Jaden Butler, $16,000. Kristen Dudley, $28,000. Taeja Folston, $8,000. Jada Gittens Ampatu, $8,000. Jada Good, $16,000. Catherine Goodridge, $14,000. Jalen Harewood, $20,000. Cameron Bean, $8,000. Ethan Harris, $24,000. Jaden Jacob, $12,000. Gabrielle Jones, $8,000. Carrington Maddox, $8,000. Jamal Nelson, $8,000. Kelsey Reed, $28,000. Karis Reynolds, $24,000. Christian Stepney, $30,000. These scholarships are awarded from Union College. Each of these is an award of $20,000. Maya Ampadu, Cameron Bean, J.
Jameel Joseph. Sarah Bolden, $24,000. Christian Jun, $24,000. Jada Good, $24,000. Cairo Nora, $24,000. Jada Gittens Ampadu, $32,000. Jaden Jacob, $40,000. Horace Reynolds, $40,000. Christian Stepney, $40,000. These scholarships are from Walla Walla University. Catherine Goodrich, $10,000. Sarah Bolgen, $54,000. Carrington Maddox, $46,000. Cameron Bean, $46,000. And Cairo Nora, $50,000. These awards are from Andrews University. Michaela Weathers, $32,000. Jamal Nelson, $32,000. Jaden Jacob, $32,000. Taeja Folston, $32,000. Christian Chun, $32,000. Jalen Harewood, $40,000. Jada Good, $40,000. Joelle Clay, $40,000. Sarah Bolgen, $40,000. Cairo Nora, $48,000. Ethan Harris, $56,000. Horace Reynolds, $56,000. Christian Stepney, $56,000. And Kyla Tucker, $56,000. I'd like to start off with our representative from Washington Adventist University.
Good afternoon, everyone. Congratulations to the 2023 class of Pine Forge Academy. I'm representing 2005, so it's good to be home. See another. You were born in 2005, praise the Lord. That was a good year. This year, I am the new Director of Enrollment at Washington Adventist University. That is with my pleasure. I'll be offering scholarships to the students that we have here. I'll move as quickly as I possibly can. You had a wonderful day. I'm starting with Kamala Bloomfield, $16,000. Catherine Goodrich, $16,000. Cameron Bean, $16,000. Kristen Dudley, $16,000. Michael Hayes, $16,000. Carrington Maddox, $16,000. Christian Chung, $16,000. Sarah Bolgen, $16,000. Maya Ampadu, $16,000. Carl Brewer, $16,000. Joelle Clay, $16,000. Jada Ampadu, $16,000. J. Jalen Harewood, $16,000. Jaden Jacob, $16,000. Gabriel Jones, $16,000. Jameel Joseph, $16,000. Jamal Nelson, $16,000. Jeremy Smith, $16,000. Elijah Tyler, $16,000. Ryan Samuel, $24,000. Kelsey Reed, $24,000. Kyla Tucker, $40,000. Christian Stepney, $40,000. Akia Maxwell, $40,000. And Karis Reynolds, $40,000. I want to say congratulations again on behalf of President Weymouth Spence. Just want to let you know these scholarships are specifically for your academics. In addition to these, you still have access to leadership, music, and sports scholarships up to 75% tuition. Thank you and congratulations again.
And our representative from Oakwood University.
Congratulations to the effervescent Pine Forge Academy graduating class of 2023. I am Dr. Karen Ben Marshall, and I serve as Vice President for Enrollment Services and Retention at Oakwood University. I bring you congratulations and greetings on behalf of our President, Dr. Leslie Nelson Pollard. The year was 1896. 360 acres of land, a former slave plantation, the former home of Dred Scott, founded because of a dream and a vision of Ellen G. White to train and educate people of color because they could not be educated in other schools. Not because of school choice, but because of the lack of a choice. No other schools will open their doors to train and educate young people who look like you. And so over 125 years ago, Oakwood University was founded, and I'm here today to award several scholarships so that you, the effervescent class of 2023, as you graduate still in the midst of a pandemic and in a racially, politically, and educationally challenged time in this world's history, you can continue to receive an SDA Christian education at the only SDA HBCU. So Oakwood University is proud to award individual academic scholarships to not 5, not 10, not 15, not 20, not even 30, but 34 of the 35 graduates today. This represents scholarships to almost 100% of the class of 2023. Our academic scholarships range from $6,000 to $65,000 per graduate. Today, on behalf of Oakwood University, I'm proud to award $1.1 million to academic scholarships to 34 recipients in the class of 2023. We congratulate you, we applaud you, we are proud of you. As Ms. Rowe calls your name, please come forward to receive your scholarship award and medallion.
Thank you. Maya Ampadu. $6,000. Cameron Bean, $24,000. Carl Brewer, $24,000. Kamali Broomfield, $24,000. Sarah Bulgin, $48,000. Jaden Butler, $40,000. Ever Causey, $10,000. Christian Chun, $24,000. Joelle Clay, $40,000. Kristen Dudley, $40,000. Taisha Folston, $10,000.
Jada Ampadu, $48,000. Jada Good, $48,000. Catherine Goodridge, $24,000. Jalen Harewood, $40,000. Ethan Harris, $48,000. Michael Hayes, $24,000. Jaden Jacob, $40,000. Gabby Jones, $10,000. Jameel Joseph, $10,000. Carrington Maddox, $24,000. Akia Maxwell, $65,000. Jamal Nelson, $24,000. Cairo Nora, $48,000. Amani Patel, $24,000. Kelsey Reed, $40,000. Karis Reynolds, $65,000. Ryan Samuel, $65,000. Chris Sandy, $10,000. Jeremy Smith, $24,000. Christian Stepney, $65,000. Kyla Tucker, $65,000. Elijah Tyler, $24,000. Michaela Weathers, $24,000. Congratulations on your academic and scholarship achievement, class of 2023. All right,
I have an easy job. At the end of the program and all the speeches have gone, you are now alumni of Pine Forge Academy. Congratulations. You paid your dues. So now I'm gonna ask all of the graduates, or if you attended Pine Forge Academy for 1, 2, 3, or 4 years, I will ask that you would stand. Yes, you too. This group that you see standing around the auditorium all salute you. You will go on far and wide to different colleges, different universities, but wherever you go, there's probably somebody from Pine Forge Academy that has gone before you and are there to support you and applaud you and to assist you. So know that there is an army of people that are here with you. You may be seated. Now my real job here is to go over the alumni oath. So I ask just the graduates to stand, and after I read each sentence, I ask that you would say, "I do." Do you, as an alumnus of Pine Forge Academy, solemnly pledge to do your best to uphold the standards, values, and traditions of your alma mater? All right. Do you pledge to commit yourself to the highest standard of service to humanity and actively spread the gospel of Jesus Christ? Do you pledge to provide moral, intellectual, and financial support and encourage others to attend in an effort to ensure the perpetuation of noble work of Pine Forge Academy? Do you pledge to earn your own place among the alums who, by their devotion to Pine Forge Academy and accomplishments and achievements, have brought recognition and honor to our alma mater? And lastly, do you pledge to active membership of the National Pine Forge Academy Alumni Association and spiritual fellowship with fellow alumni? You do. Well, congratulations, Pine Forge Academy alumni. You are the newest graduates of Pine Forge, and congratulations. Thank you so much. You may be seated.
Now is the official time to turn. Turn your tassel. Congratulations, graduates 2023. Good job. You may take your seats.
Please stand for the Pine Forge alma mater. Thank you.
there's one more announcement that we must remind you of. If you wish to receive your diplomas, you must return your robe to the registrar's office. When you hand your robe in, you will be given your diplomas.
Good morning. Well, afternoon now. My name is Jeremy Smith, and I'm a part of the Effervescent Class of 2023. It is an honor to be doing the benediction today, so I'm going to ask that everyone stand and bow their head and close their eyes. Dear Lord, thank you for this day, and thank you for bringing us here this morning. Thank you for continuing to keep our class and bringing us this far. Thank you for allowing your will to be done, and most of all, thank you for allowing us to have a strong ending to this chapter of our lives. Please continue to bless us and guide us in our next endeavors. Lord, you know that this journey has been long, hard, and tiring. So thank you for blessing our class with the gift of strength and perseverance. We have come this far off of nothing but the strength of your grace, your love, and your mercy. Please continue to protect us, keep us, bless us, and one day come back and save us. In the beloved and holy name of Jesus, I do pray, amen.
All right, just one last announcement. Honor Guard, Drum Corps, flag bearers, and graduates. 3 o'clock, we are closing all dorm room doors and shutting it down. We love you, we've celebrated, and now it's time to go. Thank you.